This video is going to be an introduction to exponential functions. And what I want to cover here is what the equations for exponential functions look like and how you can tell that you've got an exponential function when you've got a table of values. So the equation we're going to get to, the general equation, is going to look like this. Y equals A times B raised to the exponent X over this little triangle, which we call a delta x. But rather than jump right into this, I want to do it step by step. So let's start with an easier version of this. Here I've got an equation y equals b to the x, and I've got a table of values. Now, remember when you were doing linear equations and you had a table of values, you looked at the input column. My input column here is 0, 1, 2, and 3. And you wanted to see if you had a common difference. In other words, if you kept increasing in the input column by the same number. And we do. We keep increasing by 1 in this. And then you went to the output column. I've got 1, 5, 25, and 125. And you looked for a common difference there. Well, the common difference here, let's see. We go from 1 to 5, so that's a 4, 1 taken from 5. If I take 5 from 25, I don't get a 4. I get a 21. I'm sorry, I get a 20. So there's no common difference in this. But we've got an exponential function, so we shouldn't expect to find a common difference. What we're going to look for is something called the common ratio. Let's see how that works. Let's look at where I've got the 1 and the 5. What I want to do is look at the ratio, the fraction that I can make. If I take the number that's further down on the list, the 5, make that a numerator, take the number just above it, the 1, and make that a denominator, and then find out what that equals. Okay, well, 5 over 1 equals 5. Now let's do the next pair. I've got 5 and 25. So I'll take the number that's lower down on the list, the 25, and make that the numerator. Take the number that's just above it, which is 5, make that a denominator. I'll simplify this, 25 over 5, divide the numerator and denominator by 5, and I get a 5. And then the same thing will happen with 25 and 125. I'm going to write 125 divided by 25, reduce that, and that becomes a 5. So my common ratio is 5. Now, getting back to this general equation, y equals b to the x, the b is the common ratio. So I can just write y equals 5 raised to the x power. And let's check that. So when y is 1, this table would say that it's the same as 5 to the 0 power. That's my input. Well, 5 to the 0 power, any number to the 0 power is 1. So this works. When y is 5, what I'm going to have is 5 raised to the first power and 5 to the fifth power. I'm sorry, 5 to the first power is 5. So that works. Let's just do one more. When y is 25, it means I'm going to have 5 raised to the second power. 5 squared is 25. Okay, so this, y equals 5 to the x, is going to be the specific equation for this table of values. Okay, let's move on. Here I've got y equals a times b to the x. Let's see if we can figure out what to do with that a. We're going to do the same procedure. I look at my table of values. The input column, the x column, is 0, 1, 2, and 3, so there's a common difference there. The output column has 2, 10, 50, and 250. I want to see if I can find a common ratio. So taking this 2 and 10, I'll make the 10 a numerator, the 2 in a denominator. I'll reduce that fraction, 10 over 2, and that reduces to 5. Now I'll take the 10 and the 50. Make the fraction 50 over 10, and I can reduce that to 5. And I'll take the fraction 250 over 50, and reduce that, and I'll get 5. So my common ratio is 5, which means my b value is still 5. So now I can write y equals a times 5 to the x. Well, since I've got all these pairs of x's and y's, why don't I plug those in and see if I can figure out what the a must be? Okay, so when y is 2, I've got a times 5 to the 0 power. Well, 5 to the 0 power is 1. So 2 equals a times 1, so a must equal 2. Let's check that with at least one more. When y is 10, when y is 10, I should have 2 times 5, that was when x was 1, 5 to the first power. Well, 2 times 5 is 10. Okay, so 10 equals 10. And I could check the rest of the numbers and we would find the same thing. Okay, now I'm going to change a couple of numbers in this. What if I change this to y equals ab over ab to the x over this thing delta x? Okay, in math, delta, it's this triangle. Delta means the change in something. So I want x over the change in x. Let's see if we can figure out what that means. I'm going to change the input column. I'm going to go from 0 to 2 to 4 to 6. Okay? I've got a common difference. I'm increasing by 2, but the change from one number to the other is 2. So the change in x is 2. Let's look at the change. 2 minus 0 is 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. 6 minus 4 is 2. So delta x is 2. Okay, so I've got y equals ab times x over 2. Now, in my output column, I didn't change any of the numbers. So my common ratio is still 5. So I can put a 5 instead of the b. And I should be able to keep the a, which I found out was a 2. Okay, all I did was I went from the previous equation that I had, and I added this delta x. I changed what happens to x as we go from one set of numbers to another. So let's try that out. When y is 2, I'm going to have 2 times 5 raised to the 0 over 2. Well, 0 over 2 is 0. 5 to the 0 power is 1. So I'm going to have 2 times 1. And 2 times 1 is 2, so 2 equals 2. What happens when we have 2 and 10? Well, when y is 10, I should still have 2 times 5 raised to the x power, which is 2. My delta x was 2, so that just equals 1, 2 over 2. So I've got 10 equals 2 times 5 to the first power. 5 to the first power is 5. 2 times 5 is 10. Okay, and quickly I'll do one more. I'm running out of time. When y is 50, I should have 2 times 5. X is 4 raised to the, to the fourth power over 2. 4 over 2 is 2. So 50 equals 2 times 5 squared. 5 squared is 25. 2 times 25 is 50. Okay, so what we've got here is the full-blown equation, y equals ab raised to the x over delta x. That was the general form. In the specific form, y equals 2 times 5 raised to the x over 2. Okay, there's a bit more to say about this. I'm going to follow this up with another video, so stick around. I'll be back soon.